Hi, my name is Jackie Lee Price and welcome to Shadow Boxing. Today's guest was a standout amateur boxer and is making huge waves on the pro scene. It's Dina Thorsland. How are you doing, Dina?
Thank you, I'm doing good.
Good. So how is life treating you?
Life is treating me nicely. Like, it's tough in the camps, but that's how it works. I have to train 2 times a day and have my work beside it and my kid and 2 dogs and my house and my boyfriend. So there's a lot of going on, but the training is important. So that is what I'm doing.
A lot of juggling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And planning.
Isn't that most females' lives anyway?
Yeah, I think so. The one with ambitions, at least.
It's true. So how was, before we get on to you, how was life in lockdown? Did you guys go into full lockdown or did you kind of, you know, have part of the time out of lockdown and part in? How did it work in Denmark?
Well, in Denmark, we locked down totally for a couple of weeks. There were some works that have to been done. So, for example, in the special kindergartens, some kids could go, but not all. But otherwise, we were in total lockdown and for a couple of weeks, and then it opened up a little bit, and then some could go to work only to do their job and then do the rest at home. So it was open, how can I say it, like a bit of a time.
Yeah. So how did you cope as an athlete trying to train under that situation? Did you take a little step back, take a breather, or were you training full time as much as possible?
It was kind of a special situation for me as well, otherwise the corona, because I just had gone out of my agreement with Sauerland, so we were going to do our own show. But then we have to postpone it as many things else. But then I knew, okay, I'm not going to fight for a long time now. So I had to take my break and knew when my fight was.
So just in terms of like the lockdown situation, and obviously, you know, you took a step back from the whole training and stuff. Did you learn anything about yourself within that time that you didn't already know?
No, I just had a lot of work in my garden to do.
Yeah.
So I dig a lot in my garden at that time because I had this huge, I don't know what it's called in English, but where flowers is growing, and it was really big, and I have to dig all the dirt out and then chop it off and then put dirt back in the hole again. It was awful.
But you basically got some chores done though.
Yeah.
Good. So I'd like to take it back. I know you've been a pro for quite a long time, but you're also an accomplished amateur, and there's some people over here that may not know that. So I just wanted to take it back a little bit and talk about your amateur career. And, you know, how did you get into boxing? Did you find boxing or did boxing find you?
My friend introduced me to boxing, so yeah, I think she was like, she's very feminine and not sporty type at all, and I have always been, yeah, kind of a boy, always climbing, running, doing stuff, sports, so she thought, I will take Dina with me, because she wanted to start. And then she took me, and today she has her own business with clothing, a shop, and I am professional. So it's funny to see we went our own directions. But yeah, I started and thought that was me. And then I kept going. And in a year and a half, I think I was on the national team. So it just clicked. We found each other.
Yeah. It's one of those things, isn't it? You always go with a mate to start off with, and they drift off and you stay within the sport, don't you? Have you always been good at sport, though? Or was it literally that when you got into boxing, you were like, actually, I like this and I'm good at it, so I'm going to continue?
No, not that I should brag or say I'm good at many sports, but I have always been into sport and been riding at competing level, and I have been playing soccer and handball as well. Yeah, and loved it. I loved it. When I'm done with my boxing career, I will go back and play handball again. Yeah, but I just think I like to win. And when I came into boxing, it's easier. The top for me was shorter in the boxing career, in the handball career. And I was good at it. At all my qualities, it just came easier to me to top in boxing and in handball, because I'm a strong girl, and that's just a huge potential in boxing.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting that you say you don't want to brag, because I don't know if this is a Danish thing, but it's very much a British thing that we, especially women, are not supposed to say we're good at things.
No, it's kind of Danish too.
Oh, is it? Okay. It's crazy. I mean, one of the things that I have noticed over the years that I've been involved in boxing is there are lots of females that are great at boxing, but also were a very, very high standard of football as well, which, is amazing. I'm not one of them. I'm terrible at football. And have you always had that punching power? Do you think, again, that came from being... doing the handball and all of the different sports, because you seem particularly strong?
I think it's more in my genetics. I'm physiotherapist as well. And I believe that the combination of handball and football and riding and being active in my spare time, it's good, and it will develop my motor functions as well. But because I'm strong, I think I was born that way. And then I have to work to develop that talent and to get the full potential out of it.
To be fair, I've seen some of your amateur bout. You were a strong kid then, though, as well. So, like you say, you must have genetically had that. And then all the bits and pieces you just put on top, it's like, wow, this kid is so... I always call someone younger than me a kid.
I think I'm old.
Nah. But do you know what I mean? Like, you see, you're strong, you're really nice and strong, which is a fantastic thing. And you've carried that over into the pro thing as well, the pro scene, which is... it's incredible, actually. And also, it's celebrated more now, which it's a shame that it wasn't before, but it's something that I think is amazing. It's absolutely amazing. So you turned over pro. What sort of prompted you to do that?
It was actually because I had my kid, and then I started studying as well. So I had my kid and started studying. And then I was like, I cannot be at top level in amateur, because I cannot take a week out to go to tournaments, and I cannot do all the stuff I had to do. So in professional, I could do what I wanted to do and plan my trainings and plan my camps and plan my fights. So it was more like, because it was easier to be at top level at that. But I started saying my studying is the most important, and then my boxing career will come after that. But it turned, I had to say, okay, now is my time to be a good boxer, that I can develop my skill as physiotherapist after that. So I have to prioritize my training and fights and stuff like that above my studying.
Yeah. It's an absolutely fantastic story that you've chosen not to give up a career in boxing, although you have a child. It's kind of like, okay, well, all we do is we just shift a few things around and we'll make it work. It's brilliant.
I think everything is possible in life. You just have to make a plan and do it. And try to do it.
Yeah.
There will always come a solution.
Yeah, I agree. I totally agree. You were former WBC interim world champion, and now you are the current WBO super bantamweight champion. So a lot of words. But yeah, absolutely brilliant. Interestingly, though, I don't know if you find this irritating, because you've obviously been around boxing a long time. The way that everyone keeps talking about how all of a sudden female boxing is sort of, you know, is opening up, and there's this new scene that almost nobody apart from boxers knew existed. I mean, how do you feel about that?
I don't know. I just mind my own business. It's like trash talking. I don't hear it. I don't spill my energy on it. So it's like, yeah, fine. And then I concentrate on my own again.
Yeah.
It's only when my trainer says, like, have you heard this? Have you seen this? Like, no, should I?
Yeah. I'm not a fan of trash talking.
Me neither.
But I guess it's because we come from an amateur background, and there was that whole thing of sportsmanship, wasn't there? And that's something that I've noticed about you. You are very good with your opponents. Even when you've beaten them up, there is a lovely sportsmanship after the fight, which I think is, again, really commendable.
Yeah, well, boxing to me is not personal. It's a sport, and then we perform and we do our best. We do our very best, but after that, then we're human beings again, and then I can always say hi and stuff like that. But I have met people who don't.
Yeah. I feel that some people feel that they can't function without having that kind of standoffish way. Like you said, it's nothing personal. We're here to do a job. Then afterwards, we're two human beings just trying to make a living.
Realistically, exactly.
I get the feeling from watching some of your fights, something that really tickles me, at the end of your round, you kind of give yourself this sort of an acknowledgement, a little nod of acknowledgement to how well the round went. You seem a bit of a perfectionist. Would I be correct in thinking that?
It's both in the ring and other situations as well. If I do something, I want to do it properly. And I hate when I'm not able to do that. So there are some fights where I have like been very unsatisfied with myself. And then I'm like, oh, I have to do better than that. And then when it goes good, then I thought, okay, it was a good round. Then I could go out with peace in the corner, like, okay, breathe, water, take some air, and then go again.
Because it does seem like almost you're saying to yourself, okay, that went according to plan.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I'm happy with that.
I did what my trainer said I should do. Yeah.
Yeah. It's actually, it's funny because you can see the little cogs going, not in the sense of like you're out of the fight, but it's almost like you've got, I guess that there are a few, I was having this conversation with someone the other day. There are very few athletes, I believe, as a coach, that can be in a fight and still be able to judge what's going on and change the game plan should they need to. And that's what I kind of see you going, okay, well, that happened. I can adjust that. Good, you did well. Does that make sense?
I try to see, okay, that didn't work, so how can I do differently? And then I try to make a change, and if I did make a change, then okay, that was good. I keep going with this.
Yeah. I love the fact that you're an excellent little boxer. You're very, very smart. Lots of variation. Your ring craft is just absolutely spot on. And so it's actually really nice to see somebody that has all of those components and they're able to fit them together. I mean, as a coach, I kind of like that anyway. I'm a bit of a nerd when it comes to stuff like that. But let's take it back to, you said you're a perfectionist and you don't, you know, you like to win. Are you frightened of losing? Or is there a fear there of losing?
I'm not, I want to say I'm frightened to lose, but I just really like to win. No, it's like, I'm not afraid of losing because it depends how you lose. If you have been in a fight and give your very, very best and the same did your opponent and you lose a good fight, then I can say, go to bed with peace in mind. I did what I could do. I couldn't do anything else. Then I think I will be okay with it. I don't know, but I think, but if I have this feeling that, okay, I could have done more, then I will be mad and pissed. But yeah, I have to, I don't know, but I just thought of it, like, what will I do if I lose? But I'm not afraid of losing, but I'm afraid of not performing.
Yes.
To not be there, to not do what I know I can do. That is what I'm frightened of. That is the nerves about it.
You must understand there are off days.
Yeah, exactly. There is off days, and I know it because I have them at sparring sometimes. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong today?
Yeah.
And it's that feeling I don't want to have in my fight.
Yeah.
I really don't want to have that. Yeah.
The place to have it is in sparring, isn't it?
Sorry?
I said the place to have that, to make the mistakes and have the bad days is in sparring.
Yeah, exactly. So I think it's good I have some days at that in the sparring.
So talking about your career, so you're fighting on the 26th of September. It's in Denmark. Do you ever sort of venture outside of Denmark? Because the diehard fans kind of know who you are and they want to see more.
Mm. I have been at Germany sometimes, not often, mostly in the beginning of my career, and then mostly then in Denmark, because I think it's a business plan from Sauerland when I was with them, that the people who knows me and wants to see me is here in Denmark. So it's hard to get some more ticket sale with my name in another country. So I think probably that's why, but I have always been open to do foreign boxing. So I'm like, I will take the fight if I was offered. Yeah.
Please God.
I think it would be very nice. The last fight I had, it was with this Australian girl, and 100% I wanted to go to Australia. Like, I will come.
I saw that.
I have to see my boxing career as an experience and to see the world as well, because it's a once in a lifetime experience and I will take it all. So.
Yeah. I know a boxer that takes her child with her to tournaments. Are you able to do that or does he stay at home?
Usually he stays at home, but now he's at that age, he can come. Yeah, so I have said it the last maybe two fights here that he could come and join, but his father is like, no, he shouldn't. His father is my trainer, so we argue about it, but I think we agreed to that this time he will come.
That would be nice, actually. That would be a really nice little unit there.
Yeah, it would be huge.
So what?
And another aspect of me, then I have another motivation.
Yes, and hopefully he'll get the book as well.
Yeah.
So what will the next couple of weeks look like as you run down to fight night?
Well, I still have work, so I will work and train and cut my meals a bit. That is always the same routine there. And then I have to do some medical examinations. Tomorrow I have to get an MRI scanning of my head and
Thank you very much for giving us your time. Good luck for the 26th. And hopefully we can have a chat after your fight.
Yeah, thank you. And thank you for having me here. Of course, you just say it.
If you like this video, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you're not a subscriber of Shadowboxing UK, we'd love to see you, so please go ahead and subscribe now.